Hi everyone, this is Niharika from Your Legal Career Coach. We are a mentorship platform for law students, and on our YouTube channel, you will find us interviewing students and industry professionals to make your journey easier. Today, we have with us Ms. Natasha Maheshwari. Ma'am is a 2021 graduate of the Maharashtra National Law University, Mumbai. Post graduation, she started practicing at the Delhi High Court and the trial courts in Delhi in the chambers of Brinda Bhandari. She is currently working as an associate at the chambers of Mr. Shardan Farasar. She is one of the three lawyers who were awarded the Justice J.S. Verma Fellowship in 2024. In this session, she will guide us and talk about her journey of being awarded the fellowship. Welcome, ma'am. I request you to please introduce yourself to our audience, after which we can begin with the session. Over to you.
Thanks, Niharika. No, so you summed it up. I graduated in 2021 and I moved to Delhi because I wanted to work in public law and I wanted to work at the Supreme Court primarily. So I moved to Delhi from Bombay and I first worked with Vrinda Bhandari. And I was working with her for about 2 years. She primarily practiced in trial courts and the Delhi High Court. Then I decided to, I began working with Mr. Farasat, who primarily practices, he's a senior advocate, he primarily practices at the Supreme Court. So yeah, that's, I've been working for about 3.5 years now in Delhi. So
So I believe you've shared enough about your journey. Can you please share the primary purpose of the Justice J.S. Verma Fellowship and how you came to apply for the same?
I feel like in most national universities, law schools across the country, litigation is always given, it's stepmotherly treatment, so to say. Because most people are geared towards working at law firms and or working in-house or preparing for competitive exams. And justifiably so, litigation is extremely hard. There are several entry barriers. It's a very nepotistic profession. And I think most importantly, it doesn't pay. So unless you have family backing and the social and the monetary capital to sustain you for the first 4 5 years, it becomes very difficult to litigate. And that not only for the first 4 or 5 years, even after that, because you either make it or you don't make it. Whereas in a law firm, you have a lot of stability. There's a certain career trajectory. And litigation, on the other hand, doesn't offer that much stability. So I think one of the purposes of the fellowship is to encourage young lawyers to take up litigation, primarily at the Supreme Court, because the fellowship mandates that you work at the Supreme Court for 2 years.
Right. So could you please tell us about the eligibility criteria for the fellowship and if there are any specific academic or professional qualifications required for the same?
So I think they prefer, what they've stipulated, at least when I applied, was that they prefer people with 2 to 5 years of work ex. But I think that the stipulation is preferable, so it's not a mandate as such. So I think it's just 2 to 5 years. You should have a demonstrated you should have demonstrated interest in litigation or experience in litigation. They don't mandate prior Supreme Court experience, but obviously it's preferred. And you also have to commit to be working at the Supreme Court for 2 years. So 2 years after the fellowship begins. Since my fellowship began in January of 2024, so I have to commit to working at the Supreme Court till December of 2025.
Right. So, prior
Yeah.
litigation experience, so to say, is not required, is that what you're saying?
No, so prior litigation experience is required, preferably between 2 to 5 years of prior litigation experience. Yeah.
Right. So if I'm
So
working
I
at a
think
firm,
all the before
please.
So if you as I said, it's preferable.
Right.
I don't think they would, if you're working at a firm, but firms also have dispute resolution teams.
Right.
So if you're working at a firm and you're working at a dispute resolution team, I'm sure they'll consider
Right.
your application. And I'm sure, I mean, that's also, I mean, it fits the criteria. I'm not sure how someone with, say, if you were in a GC team at a firm would be eligible or would be able to demonstrate prior in, like interest in litigation. But I think if you're working at a firm and you have a sufficient amount of litigation experience, that would be fine.
Could you walk us through the application procedure for the same and or like tell us what documents or materials are required as a part of the application process?
So I had to submit three things. One was my CV. Then I had to submit an SOP, which was just demonstrating why I wanted to apply for this fellowship, why I was interested in litigation, why I wanted to work at the Supreme Court in particular. That was the SOP. And the third thing was an essay in which I described the best case I had worked on or a case that I was following very closely, preferably a case before the Supreme Court. I had worked on cases that were adjudicated by the Supreme Court, so I was able to write about that. But if you hadn't worked on it, then even a case that you were following, just basically writing about it, writing about how you formulated arguments or what interested you in it and why you were observing it, what was the question of law that was involved, what the outcome was, or whether it was pending. So those were the two essays, and then my CV, and then after that there was an interview. So the interview was basically conducted by, in my case, I think there were four of the trustees. So the chairperson of the trust, Justice Aftab Alam, and there were three or four other trustees. Yeah.
So could you tell us about the questions that were asked in the interview?
So they were very, I mean, it was not like it was not technical at all. So it was very, they were HR questions in essence, you know, whether I was committed to working at the Supreme Court for 2 years. I was already working with Mr. Farasad by then, so I didn't have to leave my job and join someone else. But if you're not working at the Supreme Court, you will have to, and if you're working in another city, you will have to move to Delhi. And you will have to work with someone or work at a firm which primarily works on matters that are, or I mean, if you're also independent. So one of my peers who also got the fellowship, he's independent. So yeah, you have to have. So and just other questions. They asked me about my internships. They asked me about basic questions about my job. Nothing usually. It was about a 10-minute interview. It wasn't. It was very easy. I was just chatting with them in essence.
So like what are the key qualities or achievements that the selection committee looks for in applicants, and how can one make their application stand out?
I think. Just demonstrating love for litigation. I have always wanted to litigate, for instance. I knew from the first year of law school that I wanted to litigate. I only did litigation internships. I worked at a firm for a month, but I was also working with the dispute resolution team at that time. So that was also, in essence, a litigation internship. I worked with a judge for about 9 months in the Bombay High Court. And, my first job was lit in litigation. My second job was in litigation. I know this is what I want. I'm very sure that this is what I want to do with my life. And I feel like just demonstrating that sort of commitment and love for litigation is all they're looking for. And of course, also, I've been lucky to work with two fantastic bosses. And who've given me the opportunity to work on some of, I mean, India's biggest public law cases. And I was very lucky to be able to speak about that in my SOP and my other essay and on my CV. So I think that helped. Sports.
So if you had to tell about any particular resources or mentors or experiences that helped you in the application process, apart from what you just said.
I think honestly, I didn't speak to too many people about it. Like, I mean, to meet people who were senior to me, I spoke to my current boss. I spoke to my peers a lot. I spoke to my colleagues. I made them vet my essays and my CV, and I just discussed the ideas that I had with them and figured out what case I should speak about. I mean, they helped me. They went through my legal essay, my statement of purpose, and just gave me inputs. And honestly, I think that's all you can do. I think more than and before the interview, I asked a couple of people to like give me like mock interview questions and just figured out what I would say. Just basic interview questions, you know, like tell me about yourself. You don't want to stutter when people are asking you these questions.
Right.
So that's it. That's all the prep I did.
Right.
I didn't really speak to too many people about it, or I didn't speak to, besides my peers. My peers really helped me.
Right. That's an
Yeah.
unusual response, but that's great.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like I don't think SOPs or your CV or your essay, I mean, beyond a point, I feel like your peers, your friends, your colleagues know you best.
Right.
So I just turned to them for help, and I knew what I wanted to say. So
Right.
I feel like too many cooks just spoil the broth, you know. Like
Right.
if I went to 15 people who were, I mean, senior to me, they would give me 15 different pieces of advice.
Right.
So I knew what I wanted to say. I just needed someone to run it by. So that's what
Right.
I did.
Right.
Yeah.
So, what does the fellowship entail, and what kinds of responsibilities or tasks are the fellows typically assigned?
So, you know, there's no responsibility or task. See, as I said, I was already working with Mr. Farasat, who primarily practices at the Supreme Court, when I got the fellowship. So if you're not working with the Supreme Court senior or with an AOR or with an advocate who primarily works on matters in the Supreme Court, then you will have to, if you're based in Delhi, then of course you can just join someone. If you're not based in Delhi, then you'll have to move to Delhi,
Right.
and you'll have to be working in Delhi at the Supreme Court for 24 months.
Right.
Other than that, there is no commitment as such or
Okay.
no task. But what basically happens is, I mean, they give me a stipend. The stipend is about 30,000 per month. And I mean, yeah, so basically that's about it. And I have access to all the subscriptions that I would need. So for instance, Manupatra, SCC, Live Law, Bar and Bench. Of course, there's a whole board of trustees part of the fellowship trust. And of course, I can turn to them for advice or help. In the past, they have helped people find a job if they're unhappy at the place that they're currently at, or help them with mentorship or any sort of career advice that you require, which is great because the trust comprises people who are either senior advocates or ex-judges or sitting judges of the High Court or the Supreme Court, or partners at law firms. So it's great to be able to turn to people for advice or help if you need it.
Right.
So yeah, that's about it.
How has the fellowship impacted your legal career and professional growth so far? And how can it contribute to one's prospects in litigation, particularly at the Supreme Court level?
So, you know, I feel like, I mean, litigation can be very, I mean, you can enter a rut, and it can be very demotivating at times, because again, as I've said, the hours are long. You don't get, I mean, as compared to my peers, I don't get paid the same amount as someone working at a law firm, right? That's just not how litigation salaries work. And also, I don't have any fixed like work routine. Like, I could be working on Sunday till like 2 a.m. or I could be working 7 days a week or for the entire month at times. So there's no structure as such, and that can be quite demotivating. Of course, you crave stability, you crave recognition, you crave just being able to do a lot of things that litigation doesn't give you. And I think with the fellowship, because you're also getting more money. I think that really helps.
Right.
That helps you just survive the initial years, because of course after once you go independent and once you're a little more senior in the profession, you start earning money and you get your own clients. But the initial years can be very hard, and which is why litigation also has so much attrition. So I think what really helps with the fellowship is that it just encourages you to stay within litigation, and for people from all backgrounds to work in the field. Because I mean, so you get your salary, you get the fellowship, you also get access to various resources. So for instance, if you've just gone independent, you don't need to spend on live law, bar and bench, SCC, Manupat, all of which can be extremely expensive. And of course it was there were when the fellowship when I got the fellowship, there was an event that was held where all the trustees congregated, and there were people from the field, and there were articles that were published. So it's nice to get that sort of recognition, especially because I'm a first generation lawyer. So I don't really have any I didn't really before I joined, I didn't have any mentors, or I didn't have someone who was steering me through the way. So it's nice to have people who are I mean, people who I can go to for advice, and people who I can turn to and just get that recognition.
Lastly, ma'am, what would be your advice to law students and young lawyers aspiring to apply for this fellowship?
You know, I don't know what advice I'd have for people who are applying for this fellowship, but to young lawyers, I think the only advice that I wish more people would just join litigation. I know it can be it can be very taxing. It can be I mean, but it's also very, very rewarding. I think this is one of the most rewarding professions, just working on. There are so many, you can work on a wide variety of matters. So today I could be working on some property dispute. Tomorrow I could be working with the I could be working on a housing rights matter where I'm helping stop the demolition of a jhuggi or a jhopdi. And that can be very fulfilling. Or I can be working on a I can be helping a woman who's going through a very bad divorce or a domestic violence case. So I feel like litigation offers you a broad range of cases and a broad range of matters and that you can work on, and that can be very fulfilling and gratifying. So I feel like that's all I would tell people, to maybe try, give it a shot. And then fellowships like this help you, encourage you to continue staying in this profession by giving you the added incentive of earning more money and getting all these subscriptions and getting that recognition and just helping you along the way. So that's about it.
With this, I believe we have covered all the important things that we needed to know about the fellowship. Thank you so very much, ma'am, for accommodating our request despite your busy schedule. I'm very positive this video will be of utmost help to everybody watching it. I wish you
Thank
the best for
you.
your journey ahead, ma'am. Thank you.